Hello friends, this is Professor S.S. Dade. Now in this session, we are going to discuss the distribution system, very important topic from the power system 2. Now, particularly in this session, we are going to discuss what is meant by distribution system, what are the main components of the distribution system, and how that distribution system is classified. Friends, as we know that the entire power system network is divided into three major parts. That parts are power generation, power transmission, and power distribution. The part of power system which distributes the electrical power for the local use is known as distribution system. That means distribution system is a system between the substation fed by the transmission system and the consumer meter. Okay, that is called as distribution system. It consists of feeders, distributors, and servicemen. Every distribution system consists of feeders, distributors, and servicemen. Now, let me explain all the important components of distribution system one by one in detail. So this is the single line diagram of distribution system in which feeders, distributors, and servicemen are shown. Now first of all, we will see what is meant by feeder. Actually, that feeder is a conductor which connect the substation to the area where power is to be distributed. In this single line diagram, feeder is connected from substation to the point C, also connected from substation to the point D, and also from substation to point A. These are the feeder conductors. In feeder, one very important point you have to keep in mind that tappings are not allowed on the feeders. Therefore, current is constant. As tappings are not allowed, therefore, current in the feeder is constant. Now, while designing the feeder, the important consideration is the current carrying capacity. Because no any tapping is allowed on the feeder, therefore, current throughout the feeder is constant, and hence, the current carrying capacity is the important consideration while designing the feeder. Now, let's move to the second component, distributor. In this single line diagram, we have the distributor CB, distributor CD, distributor AD, and distributor AB. That line represents the distributors. Friends, a distributor is a conductor from which we can take the tappings to supply the consumers. Means tappings are allowed on the distributor. As tappings are allowed, current is not constant throughout the distributor. Therefore, while designing the distributor conductor, the important consideration is the voltage drop along its length. The important consideration for the design of distributor is voltage drop along the length of distributor. That is very important point. Now, the third component is servicemen. Actually, that servicemen is a small cable which connect the distributor to the consumer terminal. That means a cable which connect the distributor to the consumer meter is known as servicemen. So we have to see the classification of distribution system. Now distribution systems are classified into different types on the basis of nature of current, on the basis of type of construction, and on the basis of scheme of connection, distribution systems are classified into different types. Now, depends upon the nature of current, distribution system is classified as DC distribution and AC distribution. And normally we are preferring the AC distribution system for the power distribution purpose because of economical aspect. And the second important point, that is type of construction, distribution systems are again classified into two types, that are overhead distribution system and underground distribution system. In that also, because of economical aspect, we are preferring overhead distribution system for the power distribution purpose. And the last important point, scheme of connection, depends upon the connection scheme. Distribution systems are classified into following three types, which are very important, and in this session we have to focus on that three types of connections. The first type is radial system, second one is ringman system, and third one is interconnected system. Now, depends upon the scheme of connection, we have three different types of distribution systems. We will see one by one in detail. Now, according to the connection scheme, we have first type, radial system. Now, this figure shows the single line diagram for radial distribution system. In that, first figure is for DC distribution system, and the second figure represent AC distribution system. Now, in this type of connection, separate feeders are radiated from a single substation and feeds the distributor at one end only. Only one path is connected between each customer and substation. Therefore, electrical power flows along the single path. In this figure, we have feeder OC. That feeder OC feeds the distributor at point A. Feeder OC feeds the distributor AB from point A, and it employed this radial distribution system is employed when power is generated at low voltage and substation is at the center of load. That time only we can prefer this radial system for the power distribution system. Now, this system has lot of drawbacks, lot of disadvantages. We will see what are the drawbacks of radial distribution system. Now, first drawback is the end of distributor nearer to the point, nearer to the feeding point will be heavily loaded. Means in this system, distributor AB, the nearer part of that distributor AB is heavily loaded. That is first drawback of that radial distribution system. And second drawback is, if any fault occurs on the feeder or distributor, the result is cut off the supply of consumer. If any type of fault occurs on the feeder or distributor, okay, that will cut off the supply of consumer. That is second drawback. And one more drawback that system have, consumer at the distant end of the distributor subjected to the serious voltage fluctuation when load changes. That means the consumers which are connected at the distant end, that means away from the feeding point, whatever the consumers are connected to the distributor, that are subjected to the serious problem of voltage fluctuation because of the changes in the load. Hence, this type of connection scheme is used for only short distance. It is useful for only short distance. Now, let's move to the second type of distribution system, that is ringman system. In this system, primaries of the distribution transformer form a ring or closed loop. The circuit of loop starts from the substation bus bar and make a loop through the area where we have to distribute the power, and again it returns to the substation. In this figure, substation supplies to a closed feeder L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S. The distributors are tapped from different points, that is point O, point M, and point Q. Now there are some advantages over the radial system. The advantages are very less voltage fluctuation at the consumer terminal, and another advantage is this system is reliable as each distributor is fed via two feeders, hence easily we can maintain the continuity in the supply. These are the advantages of ringmain distribution system. Now we have to see how we can maintain the continuity in the supply. For that, let's consider there is a occurrence of the fault on the distributor S, L, M. Now let me show. On the distributor S, L, M, on that distributor, if suppose fault is occurred at point F, that time we can supply that particular feeder via S, R, P, O, N, M. In this way, in case of occurrence of the fault, we can supply the feeder and we can maintain the continuity in the supply. So that's about the ringmain distribution system. Now we have to go for third type, interconnected distribution system. Now this is the single line diagram of interconnected distribution system. When feeder ring is supplied by two or more generating stations or two or more substations, it is called as interconnected distribution system. Now in this diagram, substation S1 and S2 supplies the closed feeders at point D and C respectively. This type of connection increases the service reliability and also increases the efficiency of the system. That interconnected system has many advantages over the previous systems because this system is fed by two substations. It increases the service reliability to the customers. And second important advantage is if any area is fed from one generating station during the peak load hours, that can be fed from other generating stations, and which will reduces the reserve power capacity and hence increases the efficiency of the distribution system. Now these are the advantages of interconnected distribution system. Friends, I hope that you have got the different types of distribution systems depends upon the connection scheme. Thank you.